Welcome back to College Hill Farm. Well, today's the day. I was worried about the stack, but what I'm finding now that I'm taking a lot of boards off, given about two more years, these might have been unusable. But it looks like the bulk that's in this stack that I took apart and stacked over here is dry because I put wide boards on the top to shelter the rain off, to run the rain off, and I tilted the thing so it would run off the length of the boards. So they're not really wet down in the stack. So that's good. Now, if you're wondering, you'll notice that I'm only selecting 6-inch wide boards and not the foot wide boards. Well, there's method to that madness. These are for the that go up on top of the shed. Okay, these are the purlins that go on top of the tractor shed. So I don't want to have to raise those 100-pounders up there. Okay, does that make sense? Those big wide boards are very heavy. They're not 100 pounds. I don't know how much they weigh, but they weigh a lot, and I'm not as strong as I used to be. So I'm picking 6 to 8 inch boards width. It doesn't matter about how wide they are for these purlins. I need 4 sets of purlins. That's 25, that's 100 feet. I need 100 feet of purlins because I'll need 4 purlins across the top of the tractor shed. So I've got to get out here and get enough of these to have 100 feet worth. And I've probably got 55 feet worth right now. And I'm gonna go and start putting these up, and then I'll come back as I need to and get more. I'm just gonna leave my hoe out here. I've got another hoe up at the shed. And I've gotta figure out a way to get these up on the roof without killing myself. So I'm probably gonna raise these just exactly like I raised the 2x6 rafters. And then I can pull them up and then twist them around after I get up there. So, okay, let's go work a little. 12 feet. Nope. Okay, hi folks, it's the next day. The other day I just pooped out getting the purlins out of the pile. And I've got about 90 feet of purlins. I'll have to get a couple more out of the pile, but these weigh so much more than the, I'm breathless. These weigh so much more than the 2x6s. I mean, a lot more. So, yeah. So I'm struggling to get these on the roof, but I'm getting them up there. I don't know if I'll video all of them going up, but I'll video at least a couple. I put the little things on the side so I could just slide the purlins to them and stop it right there and screw them down. Doing this stuff solo is kind of tough, but it's what I've opted to do, so yeah, get at it, you know? Yeah. Okay. Time to get at it. bit.
Or is it the screw? It's the screw. Thank you. Right.
That's not good.
screw and strip. Well, now I'm going to have to break it. Dang it. Yeah. Use this screw. Break up.
Okay, this screw is stripped out. Now I had a couple of these in my pocket. The screw head itself is stripped out. I thought, well, I'll try and see if I can get them to go in. Now I've got one that's about that far down. It won't go in, it won't go out. So I'm going to have to take a hammer and break it off. What a pain in the butt.
good.
Okay, I think that's where I'm going to end the video today. My legs are telling me it's time to stop. So, I couldn't hardly come down the ladder that after I put that last screw in, my legs didn't want to bend. So, it's time for me to quit. So, I'll work again at it tomorrow. Do what you can for as long as you can. All right, now, if you like this stuff, this homesteading, do-it-yourself kind of thing, be certain to come on out to the channel and subscribe. We do this homesteading stuff every week, sometimes once, sometimes five videos. Just depends on what's going on in the homestead that week. Now, if you hit the little bell when you come to the channel, it'll notify you when we upload a video. We upload on Sunday, Tuesday, and Thursday. Now, with that being said, it's time for me to get on to the next thing.